Oatmeal cranberry cookies with walnuts.
Mmm.
That's a good cookie, man. Ever wonder why you start to drool at the mention of free donuts? Well, it ain't because they're free. How about as a kid? We were so excited for all the Halloween candy we got trick-or-treating. You think you want to eat all of it, only to feel terrible after just a handful. And the culprit? Dun-dun-dun. Sugar. What's happening, good people? I'm Alzo Slade, here with Nat Geo, to break down how everything you experience and consume on a daily basis can affect your body in ways you may not expect. So, let's dig in. Right now, what does sugar do to my body? Around the world, we're eating a lot of sugar, nearly 200,000 tons per year. That's over half the weight of the Empire State Building. Now, before we get into why we crave sugar so much, let's look at how its seductive sweetness came into our lives in the first place. Sugarcane was domesticated 10,000 years ago. Over time, our sweet tooth grew. Demand for sweet treats spiked during Prohibition, with many turning to soda and ice cream in place of the booze. By World War II, we craved sugar so much that the U.S. Navy declared supplying ice cream to the troops a matter of the highest priority. In the time of George Washington, the average American only ate 6 pounds per year. These days, Americans devour more than 100 pounds of sugar annually. But not all the sugar we eat is bad. Around a third of it is naturally occurring in fruit and other foods. The real problem is how much is added to our food and drinks. The American Heart Association recommends limiting added sugar intake to about 6 teaspoons for women and 9 for men. In the US, we're eating 2 to 3 times that amount. So after that one can of soda, yeah, you're more than done for the day. You may say, all right, I know what I'm gonna do. No more cookies and ice cream. That'll do it. Not really. You'd be surprised where that added sugar is hiding. So, how can you tell you're eating too much? It starts with the package labels. But beware, there's trickery afoot. Added sugar could be hiding in the ingredients of as many as 61 different names. That's some secret agent level deception. But that's why the FDA stepped in. Until 2016, package labels were only required to list total sugars, and it was hard to tell if there was an extra punch of sweetness inserted. Now, the guidelines list added sugars separately, so you can decide what you want to limit or avoid altogether. Better to make your own decision rooted in information instead of having it shoved into your body unknowingly. Knowledge really can be power. All right, class. We're gonna dive into what's going on inside our bodies and minds that's making us crave the sweetness. Back when folks lived in caves, humans and animals relied on their sense of taste to keep them alive. Sweet foods were usually safe, and bitter foods were dangerous. Fast forward about 10,000 years, and we've grown to associate sweetness with pleasure. To learn a little more about how this works, we're gonna turn to National Geographic editor, Ali Yang.
So something mystifying about food addiction is there's nothing in food that's like nicotine that is in itself an addictive substance. However, when we look at sugar, it has the same kind of pathways from our mouth to our gut to our brain that mimics what it's like to have substances like nicotine and alcohol. When you eat something sweet, in a matter of milliseconds, it starts this circuit in the brain, it travels along the vagus nerve, this message of, she just ate something sweet. It's amazing. When we eat sugar, we'll have a dopamine response. Dopamine is associated with learning. It tells us that what we're doing is good for our survival. It can be a very, very strong urge that even if you're full, you're gonna reach for it anyway.
Thanks, Ali. So, how does a high sugar diet impact our bodies long term? We're getting hit hard from all the angles. There's a 38% higher chance you'll die from heart disease, and your survival rates for certain cancers, it drops. Your skin even repairs slower, leaving you with wrinkles at a rate similar to smoking. And like heavy drinking, excess sugar can lead to liver disease. Oh, no, 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 no. I'm not done yet. You're also 44% more likely to lose teeth as bacteria feeds on sugars in your mouth and destroys your enamel. Dudes, yeah, we gotta look out. We have a 23% higher chance of developing mood disorders like depression. Quick bad news summary. Sugar can result in a raggedy heart, soggy looking skin, fatty liver, all while being depressed. Sugar ain't really all that sweet after all, is it? I know some of y'all are looking at me asking, so what am I supposed to do, Alzo? I won't be there to knock the slushy out of your hand, but I can help you lay out some ideas. Let's start by examining what happens when we cut back on the candy salads. Your risk of type 2 diabetes and heart disease are way lower. Inflammation goes down. You get a boost to your immunity and energy. Also, your sugar cravings will decrease, which means it'll be easier to lose weight and keep it off, and you'll get less cavities. You can even slow down the early wrinkles, and a healthier diet can lower your risk of depression. I mean, maybe you'll be less depressed just by having less wrinkles, because we all know when you look good, you feel good. Little incremental changes over time make a difference, and you'll even find your taste buds will adapt. When you're baking, try swapping sugar for applesauce, or even use half the sugar called for. They say you probably can't tell. Try enhancing foods with warming spices like ginger, allspice, cinnamon, and nutmeg, or flavor extracts like almond, vanilla, or lemon. Remember, knowledge is power. Take a minute to read the labels and be aware of where the sugar comes from. Limit what sweetness you add, and you'll find a way to kick that habit, or at least make it feel more manageable. Now it's your turn. You think you can cut back? Or do you have a go-to sugar swap out? Let us know, and we'll see you on the next episode. Until then, stay sweet. Class dismissed.